10 million Australians are set to receive a tax cut with the government's multi-billion dollar economic plan expected to pass the Senate. Labor's pulling its opposition after four key crossbenchers shifted their support to the coalition.
It was a budget and tax plan Scott Morrison was banking on.
Welcome to the year of the first budget surplus in 12 years, Mr. Speaker.
And having just lost an election opposing both, late this afternoon, Labor finally conceded defeat.
We won't oppose the full package if it comes to the Senate unamended, because our highest priority is to make sure that Australians do receive that tax cut next week.
Instead, vowing to review Stage 3 of the seven-year, $158 billion plan at the next election.
All sides of politics review, depending upon economic circumstances. We will do that. We'll put forward our own policies.
Labor capitulating after Jackie Lambie confirmed she would back the government.
I've got small businesses down there in sufferance. So you know what, I'm not sitting around on this for another 4 or 5 weeks while we play argy-bargy.
In return for action on Tasmania's multi-million dollar social housing debt.
My negotiation isn't with the media, okay? I'm on goodwill here. I'm quite sure there'll be a lot more detail on that in the next 6 or 8 weeks.
The government's chief negotiator says we'll have to wait.
Do you agree to wipe out Tasmania's social housing debt at a cost of $157 million?
What we've agreed is to work with Senator Lambie in relation to policy issues that she's raised with us.
I don't know what the quid pro quo is, or I don't know what deal has been done with the government, but what I do know is that I think she's played this very, very smart.
Corey Bernardi and Centre Alliance will also back the plan in full in return for action to drive gas prices down.
There is no agreement that says if you vote for the tax cuts, we will do this.
An utter refusal by the government to give any details of this special deal.
Your position has got no credibility. You're all over the place. You've got more positions on tax than in the Kama Sutra, quite frankly.
The only opposition coming from an unlikely alliance, One Nation.
Tax offsets are a sugar hit.
And the Greens.
Jackie Lambie thinks she's a hero this morning, but what she is a bloody sellout.
Having tried and failed to simultaneously deny higher income earners a tax cut while matching ones promised to low and middle income earners, Labor believes its best political shot is a tactical retreat, tonight attempting to shift the economic pressures onto Scott Morrison.
What programs and services will be cut to fund Stage 3 of the government's tax scheme?
The Prime Minister.
None.
In a worsening economy, others in the coalition are far less certain.
And Chief Political Correspondent Brett Mason joins us now from Canberra. Brett, this is a big win for Scott Morrison.
Well, Darren, it sure is. The opposition effectively delivering the government's key election promise. These are live pictures inside the Senate chamber right now, where the opposition is supporting in full the coalition's seven-year, $158 billion tax plan. And insiders tell me they really had no choice on this, despite having called it irresponsible and reckless all throughout the election campaign and the first sitting week of the 46th Parliament. Even if the crossbench had endorsed their amendments, carving off the higher income tax cuts and bringing forward other cuts for low and middle income earners, it would have ping-ponged back to the House of Representatives, where the coalition would have used its majority to send it back. It really was a case of all or nothing for Labor. And this afternoon, caucus decided that ultimately it was far less damaging to wave these tax cuts through rather than stand in the way of tax relief for some 10 million Australians. Of course, some Labor supporters tonight are asking, well, what does the opposition stand for, having campaigned so strongly against this tax agenda? And for Scott Morrison, this victory really hasn't come at much of a price. The coalition under his leadership was already working towards driving down energy prices. It had began to review a lot of its energy policy anyway, and underwriting a couple of $100 million in the grand scheme of things in terms of Tasmanian state government debt isn't really a huge price to pay. So it's safe to say, Darren, that Scott Morrison is pretty happy with his first week here in Canberra.
Okay, thank you, Brett. Brett Mason there from Canberra.